Einstein's theory of general relativity was revolutionary on many levels. One of its many groundbreaking consequences is that mass and energy are interchangeable at rest. The immediate implication is that you can make mass, tangible matter, out of energy, thereby explaining how the universe as we know it came to be during the Big Bang, when the heck of a lot of energy turned into the first particles. But there may be much more to it. Published recently in the Journal AIP Advances, physicist Melvin Vopson of the University of Portsmouth proposes an experiment that could confirm that information is the fifth state of matter in the universe. That would change physics as we know it. Since the first magnetic hard disk drive has been invented, digital information storage technologies have radically transformed our modern society. In binary code, digital information is stored as logical ones and zeros, known as bits. Bits of information can be stored in any material capable of displaying two distinctive and switchable physical states, magnetic, electric, optical, and resistive, by allocating a logical zero or one to each physical state. Digital information has become so entrenched in all aspects of our society that the recent growth in information production appears to be unstoppable. For instance, each day on Earth, we generate 500 to the power of 106 tweets, 294 to the power of 109 emails, 4 to the power of 106 gigabytes of Facebook data, 65 to the power of 109 WhatsApp messages, and 720,000 hours of new content added daily on YouTube. In 2018, the total amount of data created, captured, copied, and consumed in the world was 33 zettabytes, ZB, or the equivalent of 264 to the power of 1021 bits, where 1 ZB is 8 to the power of 1021 bits. This grew to 59 ZB in 2020 and is predicted to reach 175 ZB by 2025. In 2019, Vopson published a study suggesting that information has mass. Information is equivalent to mass and energy, existing as a separate state of matter, a conjecture known as the mass-energy-information equivalence principle. This would mean that every bit of information has a finite and quantifiable mass. For instance, a hard drive full of information is heavier than the same drive empty. This study suggested that information is the fundamental building block of the universe with physical mass. All elementary particles store information about themselves, similar to the way humans have DNA. Now, the new study has designed an experiment, which, if proved correct, means this study will have discovered that information is the fifth form of matter, alongside solid, liquid, gas, and plasma. In these two studies, the physicists proposed two important conjectures. A. The mass-energy-information equivalence principle, stating that information transcends into mass or energy depending on its physical state. B. The existence of intrinsic information underpinning the fundamental characteristics of elementary particles in the universe, implying that stable, non-zero rest mass elementary particles store a fixed and quantifiable value of information about themselves. These so-called information conjectures also imply that the information is a form of matter, called the fifth state of matter or the fifth element. The mass-energy information equivalence principle combines Rolf Launder's application of the laws of thermodynamics with information theory, which says the information is another form of energy, and Claude Shannon's information theory that led to the invention of the first digital bit. These theoretical proposals made specific predictions about the mass of information and the most probable information content per elementary particle. However, testing these conjectures is not trivial. For instance, a 1 TB hard drive filled with digital information would gain a mass of only 2.5 times 10 to the power of minus 25 kilograms compared to the same erased drive. Measuring such a tiny change in mass is impossible, even with the most sensitive scale in the world. The new study proposes an experiment of particle-antiparticle collision. Since every particle is supposed to contain information, which supposedly has its own mass, that information has to go somewhere when the particle is annihilated. In this case, the information should be converted into low-energy infrared photons. According to the study's predictions, an electron-positron collision should produce 2 high-energy gamma rays and 2 infrared photons with wavelengths around 50 micrometers. The physicist adds that altering the sample's temperature wouldn't influence the energy of the gamma rays but would shift the wavelength of the infrared photons. This is important because it provides a control mechanism for the experiment to rule out other physical processes. The picture shows a diagrammatic representation of the positron electron annihilation process. A. The standard positron electron annihilation process produces 2 511 kiloelectronvolts gamma photons and B. Positron electron annihilation process that produces 2 511 kiloelectronvolts gamma photons and 2 additional low energy photons from information erasure. The annihilation process converts all the remaining mass of the particles into energy, typically gamma photons. Any particles containing information are converted into low-energy infrared photons. The study predicts the exact energy of the infrared photons resulting from erasing the information. This work could demonstrate that information is a critical component of everything in the universe, and a new field of physics research could emerge. This principle might help understand some science mysteries, such as dark matter, dark energy, and the black hole information paradox.